Wire strippers like this one are incredibly handy tools, but a lot of times we don't know all of the features and functions that you'll find on here. Obviously, we know that they can strip wires, but there's so much more that these little guys can do. Let's dive into each one of their functions to make sure you're totally familiar with it so that next time you need that, you know exactly how to use this tool. Obviously, the first thing we need to cover is the wire stripper itself. You'll immediately notice that there's two sets of numbers and they're off by two from one side to the other. So over here, you can see the AWG, which means gauge. So this is for solid core wires or solid gauge. And then over here, the STR stands for stranded. Now these are different because they need to be stripped differently. I'm gonna show you a 12 gauge wire. This is 12 gauge non-metallic or Romex wire. Romex is just a brand name, but we use it pretty universally. And you can see it's just a cut wire, very solid, not a lot going on there. This is made of copper. This one, on the other hand, is a stranded wire, and it's made up of a bunch of individual wires in there called threads or strands. And each one of these need to be cut a little bit differently than a solid wire. You can see there's a kind of a thick insulation or jacket around there. So let's see what happens when we cut these on the wire stripper. For the solid, I'll start with the 12 gauge. I'll line it up in here, push down, and then you may want to twist a little. It just kind of depends on getting to know your individual wire strippers if that's going to be needed or not. And then once you've got that, we don't need to rock back and forth or anything. We just need to pull away like that. You've got a nice clean cut. Now the thing is, if we take our stranded wire here and we do the same thing and we do that same 12 gauge on here, we're running a little risk here. Watch what happens. I'm gonna crimp down, maybe twist back and forth a little, and then it's really not wanting to pull because this is the wrong size. But even if I can get it to do so, you can definitely tell, you get that feedback right away that this is just not the right size and it doesn't want to work. And now that I've twisted it around, I'm gonna try it again. I have to rock it to get it because this just isn't meant. I mean, you can see what I'm talking about here. There we go. Now, if you look at a close-up of this, you can see it cut all of these wires along here. This was originally quite a bit thicker, and it just cut all of those off because we used the wrong size. That's why it's crucial that you use the proper gauge when you're stripping wires for stranded versus solid. By contrast, I'm now going to use the 12 over on the stranded side, and you'll see that we get a totally different result. So I'm going to place that on the 12, crimp it solid, give it a little twist, and then we pull that off. That went much easier. And then check out the wires. Everything's looking perfectly intact. We didn't cut any of those, and the sheathing is cut right to where it needs to be. That's an ideal strip right there. For the rest of the features, I'm gonna work my way down from the top down to the bottom here. So starting at the top, we have basically a set of needle nose pliers. You can see the little teeth that are present there, and these work great for all kinds of things. One of the things that they're commonly used for is removing these little tabs that are called mouse ears on the outlets or light switches that we work with. So I can take this, it's scored. You can see there's a little line right there for it to act as a break point, and so I can twist this a couple times and then it will snap off. This one's of course taking longer than it normally does because I'm on video and it did a crap job. Anyway, you get the idea though, but you can use the needle nose pliers to grab on there. Let's see if this one does any better. I'll grab it closer to the actual score line to see if that helps. And it just wants to break anywhere but there. This is a super cheap little light switch here. This is the one that came in my house, actually. That's why I don't mind taking these tabs off, because I'm not going to use this one. But you get the idea. Even though that required a lot of torque, the needle nose pliers can handle it pretty well. These are handy for all kinds of things. Pulling wire, grabbing the end of stripped wire, different things like that. Moving down to our next section here, I don't know what the name of this is, and I don't ever see it labeled, but I call this the wire grabber. That's that little somewhat teardrop-shaped hole or opening right here underneath the needle nose teeth. And this is actually super handy. One of the things I like to use it most for is going back to stripping here. If I've got a little wire like this, so this is some 12 gauge solid, so let's say take this and I'm having a hard time getting that piece off there, then I can use the soft opening right in there to grab it and pull off. And so it grabs onto it really nicely, makes it pretty easy. So it's great for that kind of thing where you don't want to mar or necessarily use the teeth on there. You just need a soft opening. Then this little wire grabber hole is pretty perfect for that. Now, if you know the name of this, I'd love to hear that. I can't seem to find anything about that anywhere. So if you do know that, please leave that in the comments below. Just a reminder that as I'm showing you these different tools, if you want links to any of these or to learn more about them, I keep these all on my idea lists on my Amazon page. So you can check those out there. You can see the specific tools that I'm showing here or the closest ones that I can find. And keep in mind that these are all vetted tools so that you know that these are ones that I've tried out and I trust and I would recommend to you, not just whatever tool I could find. So be sure to check the links in the description to learn more about that. Now, we already covered the wire stripping, but one thing I didn't show you is that if you're not sure exactly what wire gauge you're working with, then if you have a ground available from that same gauge and you can use the little holes, just squeeze those handles together to where they make nice circles like this. And then we can see if we try to put it in the 14 gauge, for example, it just doesn't fit in there. If we put it in the 12 gauge, it fits in just right. It just barely fits, it's a tight fit. So we know that this is 12 gauge cable. So if you've got a hot and neutral and a ground, for example, then you can use the ground to try to figure out exactly what that gauge is just by feeding it through here like so. Moving down the wire strippers, the next tool here is these two little identical holes right here. They're the same size, so there's not a different one for solid or stranded. Those labels have to do with the wire stripper itself. These two are the same and they have one basic function, and that is to make hooks for your wires to apply them to terminal screws. So I can feed a wire in like this. And what I like to do is have it so that it just sticks out a little bit like you see there. I just want a little bit protruding from there, maybe even less, honestly. So it's just barely gonna grab on. Then bend it around like so, and then you get yourself a nice little hook. Now I can see on this one, I definitely don't have enough jacket or sheathing removed for this to do a proper job. So on this one, for example, I'll strip off a little more just to show you exactly how this can work. So I'll take my 12 gauge, twist it a bit, peel it off, put that in just a little bit like so, wrap it around, and then I end up with something like this. And that's much more appropriate. Now, when I want to put that onto a terminal, onto a screw, I'm actually gonna make that a little bit tighter. And this is where the needle nose pliers can help you out with that. They can tighten these guys up just a bit, and those teeth actually really help because they grab onto it and make the job easy. So I'm gonna squeeze that in like so. Then when I place this on, I can hook it in like that, and that's an ideal amount of contact here. The sheathing is up on the brass plate or near the brass plate, so it's not sticking off the end, leaving any exposed area there. And then this goes all the way around, the hook's in good shape, and that's exactly what we're looking for. Next up, we have our wire cutter right here. So we have our blades, our teeth right there, and these do a great job at cutting wire. Again, remember that these are really only meant for cutting copper wire, so you're not gonna wanna put any steel or anything like that in there. But for copper, copper's soft enough that these will cut all day and do a really nice job with that. So our wire cutters are great for there. You can use these for other things. You can technically cut Romex wire, for example, like maybe you've got some 14-2, but they're not necessarily meant for that, but they'll fit and it'll typically work just fine. Moving down, we have two more holes, and these ones do have different sizes. These are called bolt cutters or bolt shears, and these are coming in two sizes. We have 632 and 832, and these are for the little bolts or screws that we typically find in electrical devices or setups. I've got one of each right here to take a look at. So on the left here, we have the 632. On the right, we have the larger and more coarse threaded 832. Now to use these, a lot of times you end up with a bolt that's just too long. It won't fit in, for example, your ceiling fixture or in the box that you've got in your receptacle. So you've got to work with that. So I'm going to take the 632, for example, here. And what you do is just thread it right into the 632 hole. On the front side, on the face, it should thread in nicely. Now you may need to squeeze these a little bit to line up the holes to get those going. And then as you thread that in, sometimes they can be a little bit stubborn depending on how well these are used and the screw itself. So if you need to, you can use a screwdriver to do the driving there. In this case, there's really no need. This fits in just fine. And then these are just shears. So if you give this a good hard squeeze, and it's not simple, it does require some wrist power here. And then I can shear this head off just like this. There it goes. So depending on the wire strippers that you have, they might be more or less difficult. But the benefit of doing this here instead of just using some cutters is that as we back this out, what it's really doing is it's re-threading. It's basically acting as a die, and it's making sure those threads are in good shape so that they can thread right into the next thing. It's usually a little harder to take these out because we're forming those threads again. And then as we get it out, check this out. Now all those threads are intact and I can just thread this right into something. It's not gonna be broken off or stubborn on that end there. It's really just ready to go, which is pretty great. On a set of wire strippers like this, that's really the end of the functionality for it. There's really nothing else other than our little tab here that will keep the handles closed, and it makes sure that it's easy to slip this inside and outside of your bag repeatedly all day if you want to keep those closed. It takes up less space and it's less likely to snag on things. But if we look at some other wire strippers, you're going to find additional functions. I'm going to grab some of my Milwaukee's here. Now these are not my favorite ones, but they're close to my favorite ones. I literally cannot find my what are called Milwaukee 7-in-1s. These I believe are called the 6-in-1s, and I've used these quite a bit, but the 7-in-1s are probably my favorite. And they have a couple of different things. One of the things they have, the 7-in-1s that I'll show you on screen here, they have lineman's pliers. Like a wider plier set on the end, which is really handy. These ones are also pretty handy though because they have a pretty aggressive set of needle nose plier tips here, and then also they are reamers. That's the other thing that they have. So if you're doing some working with some metal conduit, for example, and then you use your pipe cutter, cut everything out, and then you've got those little sharp burrs on the inside, then you can use this to ream that out.
That's enough.
The built-in reamer can be used on half-inch through one-inch conduit.
And if you take a look at the different plier sets that we have here, or wire strippers, we've got some reamers on here, some reamers on here, some reamers on here. So they're getting to be more and more common with newer wire stripper sets, and they're definitely very handy. So keep in mind, that's another tool that you might have at your disposal depending on what type of wire strippers you're using. Now, these ones you can see are a little bit different than the others, but one of the things I love is the blades on these are amazing. These do a really good job. They are overlapping blades, and they do a great job at cutting anything you need to. I thought it would be good to show a different set of wire strippers so you can see a lot of the same functions and features are there. It's just laid out a little bit differently. We have our needle nose pliers up here. We have the wire grabber in there. This one goes from 10 to 26 on the solid and then 12 to 28 on the stranded. And again, marked solid and stranded there. We have our bolt shears down here. We have the shepherd's hook or the hook hole right down here. And one thing that we didn't see on the other sets is that this one has a crimper right here. So the crimper is pretty handy. And if you see on this side, it shows insulated. For crimping, it will do from 10 to 22 gauge, and it's got non-insulated over here. Now that we've seen what a basic set of wire strippers like this can handle and all of the different functions and features on it, I thought it'd be great to show you real quickly before we wrap up some of the different options out there. There are some automatic wire strippers like this, or universal wire strippers. Pretty cool technology. There are different types of them that do different things. I personally really like the Kleins here, and they have a pretty nice setup. Basically, the idea is it doesn't really matter what gauge wire, whether it's stranded or solid, pop this in like so, and then let it pull apart, and it's gonna strip that wire off just like that. Super easy to use. So I can do that on a thicker wire that's solid like that. I can actually use the wire cutters down here, and the wire cutters on this aren't the best, but they do work. So I can cut that off. This is a stranded wire. I'll put it in the same way, and then it's gonna expose the stranded section as well. So that does a really nice job with that as well. Those are pretty handy. You don't have to worry about what size it is. You just grab them and do it. On the downside, they don't have hardly any of the other features or functions that we saw earlier. They have a cutter, they have a stripper, and that's typically about all. Similar to that are these Knipex universal wire strippers. Now, these are probably my favorite that I use. These are a little pricey, but not too bad. And if you're doing a lot of wire stripping, these are definitely worth it. Funny little cutter built in up here that again does an okay job at least. There we go, it just pops that right off and there it goes. And then this is the stranded wire again, and regardless of what size, I can just put it in there. It's got kind of a little alligator mouth in here, and then it's gonna pull that off. Now this one, depending on the length, it may or may not actually remove all of the extra sheathing. It might just cut it off like it did there. Then I can take some solid core, for example, like the 12 gauge here, feed that in, and then off it goes. So it does a great job with that. No worrying about different sizes or gauges or anything like that. Just put it in, squeeze the trigger, and you're good to go. The other cool thing is on this one, it does have your millimeter depth here, so it can remove as much or as little as you need. And then you've got your plus and minus on here to show exactly how much pressure that it's going to use essentially with it. So typically you're gonna keep it a little higher for solid wire and then a little lower for a stranded wire. So definitely a pretty handy little tool right here. At this point, you should feel like a total pro, a total boss when it comes to knowing all of these different features and functions that we just went through, including how to use some of these different ones here. If you want to learn more about some of the mistakes that DIYers commonly make with electrical work, you can check that video out right here. I'm Nils with Learn to DIY. Thanks for watching.